In this short tutorial, we are gonna fix last epoch not launching problem. Before moving on to the video, don't forget to leave a like. I recommend watching the video once before trying the solutions. The first solution consists of a few small steps. The first step is to change the game's compatibility settings. To do this, open Steam and right-click on the game. Then click on Browse Local Files from Manage. After doing this, right-click on Last Epoch and open Properties. Then click on Compatibility from the top. After that, we tick Disable Full Screen Optimizations and run this program as an admin. Click Apply and OK to save the changes we made. The second thing we need to do is to set the game to high performance. To do this, we go to Search and type Graphics Settings. After opening Graphics Settings, click Browse. What we need to do here is find the file location of Last Epoch. To find the file location of the game, you first need to find the Steam folder from the disk where Steam is installed and navigate to this location. Then double click on Common and open the Last Epoch folder. The file location you need to follow will look something like this. Select our game and then click Add. Once we have done that, we click on Options and tick High Performance. Click Save and close here. The next thing we need to do is delete the game's cache files. To do this, press the Windows and R keys at the same time and open Run. After opening Run, type %updated% in the search bar and click OK. Click on Updated from above and then double click on Local Log. After doing this, delete the 11th Hour Games folder. Doing this may cause us to lose our saved files in the game. If the game's data is only saved locally, we need to get the save of this folder that we will delete. To do this, we copy the folder and paste it on the desktop. Once we have the save, we can delete the folder here. Now, we will close unnecessary applications running in the background and programs with overlay features. To do this, we go to Search and open Task Manager. What we need to do here is close programs that we know what they do and we don't need while playing games. We also close programs with overlay features such as MSI Afterburner. We will also turn off Discord's and Steam's overlay. To turn off Discord's overlay, open Discord. Then click on User Settings and on the left side, click on Game Overlay. After doing this, if the overlay is toggled on, toggle it off. To turn off Steam's overlay, right-click on the game and open Properties. Then we toggle off overlay in the same way. The last thing we need to do is clear Steam's download cache. To do this, click on Steam from the top left and open Settings. After opening Settings, click on Downloads and then click on Clear Cache. After doing this, we will need to log back into our account. We are logged into our account. Now, you can check if the problem is solved or not. If the problem is not solved, we will move on to the second solution. Also, don't forget to like the video if you haven't already. The second solution is to change the game's compatibility mode. To do this, we need to go to the file location of the game. We go to the file location of the game as we did in the first solution. Then right-click on Last Epoch and open Properties. After opening Properties, click on Compatibility. Then click Run this program in Compatibility Mode 4 and select Windows 8. After that, we untick Disable Full Screen Optimizations and run this program as an admin. Click Apply and OK to save our changes. We changed Last Epoch's compatibility mode. Now, you can check if the problem is solved or not. If the problem persists, we will move on to the last solution. The last solution is to increase virtual memory. This solution is a bit complicated, so I recommend you to watch it carefully. To do this, go to Search and type Vive Advanced System Settings. After that, click on Settings in the Performance section. Then click Advanced from the top. After doing that, click on Change. What we need to do here is untick Automatically Manage. After doing that, we need to select the drive where the game is installed. After selecting the drive, we tick Custom Size. There are two sections here. In these parts, we will write 1.5 and 3 times our current RAM in megabyte. In the section above, Initial, we will write 1.5 times our RAM, and in Maximum, we will write 3 times our RAM. To find out how much RAM we have on our computer, right-click on the Windows icon and open Settings. After opening Settings, click on System and scroll down. After doing this, click About. In the Installed RAM section, we find out how much RAM we have on our computer. This RAM is in gigabyte. We will convert it to megabyte. To do this, we open Calculator. Then we multiply the RAM on our computer by 1024. We multiply this result by 1.5 and 3. We multiply the result by 1.5. We write the result in initial size. In the same way, we multiply the result by 3 and write the result in the maximum size section. After doing this, click Set. Here, it shows such a notification because there is not enough space on my desk. It might not show this for you. Click OK and continue. After that, click Apply and click OK. Close the last window by clicking OK. Now, we need to restart our computer. After that, you can check if the problem is solved or not. We have come to the end of the video. I hope one of these solutions fixed your problem. If the video helped you, don't forget to like the video. You can also subscribe to my channel to support me. Take care and see you in the next video.